والصلاة والسلام على خير الأنام محمد بن عبد الله وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين أما بعد. First of all, sisters, I want to apologize to come late, you know. Come from Philadelphia driving, then stuck in the traffic a little bit, and I was leaving a little late. So inshallah, we'll do better next time, inshallah ta'ala. So we're going to continue from where we left off last time in purifying our intentions in our niyyah. In every type of worship we do, we required to check our niyyah and our intentions and why we do this and that. So we continue where we left off last time from a book that we are reading from. So we left in this statement where he said, فَمَوْقِفُ الصَّحَابَةِ عَجِيبُ. The position of the companions is amazing. تَحَمَّلُوا الْأَمْرَاضَ وَالْجُوعَ وَالْمَشَاقَ وَمُفَارَقَةَ الْأَوْطَانِ وَالْأَحِبَّةِ. The position of the companions is amazing, meaning in seek knowledge, in obeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They show their patience in sickness when they are sick. Sickness never stopped them from seeking knowledge or worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wal-ju'a, also the hunger. The hunger never kept them away from studying or seeking knowledge or going to the messenger to study. Wal-mashaqa, and the hardship the person faces when you travel, when you seek knowledge, that never stopped the companions. Wa-mufaraqat al-awtani wal-ahibba, also being far away from your hometown, your below friends that you usually like to be with. All this come make difficult for a person to seek knowledge, but this never stopped them. They travel, went away, far away from their lands, far away from their friends and their beloved ones, but they went to seek knowledge because their niyyah, all this discussing their attention, the niyyah, when the niyyah is right, nothing will stop you. You're not going to have no excuses. Usually excuses come when a person don't have pure attention. It's too late, it's too far, or the book is all in the middle. I'm going to wait till they finish the book. When they get no book, I'm going to be there. Always you hear some excuses when a person who is near is not pure. So they're telling you, where you on the book? When the chapter number 15, I'm late, so I'm going to wait till we next time. So all these excuses, they never been used when the people near is pure and they want to do worship Allah Azza wa Jal. So the companions, they went through all the situations, sickness and hunger and hardship, and they left their lands and their beloved ones to go to seek knowledge. Not only that, also وَوَاجَهُ الْكُفَّارَ بِالسُّيُوفِ. They faced disbelievers in fighting. Disbelievers want to stop them from worshiping Allah Azza wa Jal. They did not sit down and watch. Rather, they fought back. إِلَى غَيْرِ ذَلِكَ. And to other than these, from the hardship that they face in seek knowledge. So, ابْتِغَاءَ مِنْهُمْ لِلْأَجْرِ وَالثَّوَابِ وَالْجَنَّةِ. Why this never stopped them? Why they continue to face hardship and trials and tribulations? Because they were after the reward from Allah Azza wa Jalla. And they were after the Jannah. They wanted to enter paradise. So once they know the reality of the Jannah, the reality of paradise, once they know what Allah promised them to receive, nothing was used as an excuse. Nothing can stop them. Nothing was able to come and become a skeptical. They keep moving because they know what they will get, inshallah, at the end. So when a person niyyah is pure, and niyyah is right, and they know at the end of these activities, at the end of this type of worship, there's a bigger reward waiting for them, they don't stop. So then the author said, "Amma nahnu fa'ila Allahil mushtaka." But as today, nowadays, we complain to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, mas'alat al-idad lil-akhirah, the issue of preparation for hereafter. والجد في ذلك عزيز عند كثير من الرجال فضل على أن النساء. So, as for we nowadays, we don't have the zeal, we don't have the strengths of the Sahaba, we don't want to do what they have done, we don't have the patience they had. we complain. We have a lot of complaints. Everything's excused. It's too far. I cannot get there on time. So I'm wait till next summer. So the issue of preparation for hereafter and the hard work is difficult to be found in men, not to mention women. So let alone women. So men, they're supposed to be stronger. They're supposed to be leaders and be in front and in front lines, or to be the one who in front and fighting and seeking knowledge. You find weakness in them. You find laziness in them. So let alone female. Illa man rahma rabbi, say, except those who Allah have mercy upon. Innahu huwa al-azizur rahim. Only few people who Allah have His mercy upon, you'll see them struggling, put their time, go away from their family to seek knowledge, go away from their wives, away from their beloved ones, as we mentioned, with difficulties, a little bit money, but they save, they go here and there to seek knowledge. Only those who Allah have His mercy upon. وَإِنَّ الْجِدَّ وَالْإِجْتِهَادَ فِي الطَّاعَاتِ يُوصِلُ إِلَى الطَّرِيقِ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ. And keep in mind, if you work harder and you keep working harder in obedience to Allah Azza wa Jal, this will lead you to be on a right path. When a person is working harder all the time, hard work is his habit. Or a habit, the end of the day, she will be reaching the right path. الَّذِي لَا عِجَاجَ فِيهِ. The path which will not be crooked, the path that will be straight, right, that will take her to Jannah. As he said, قَالَ تَعَالَى, Allah Azza wa Jalla says, وَالَّذِينَ جَاهَدُوا فِينَا لَنَهَدِيَنَّهُمْ سُبُلَنَا. And those who strive hard for our sake, those who strive hard for Allah's sake, Allah says, we will guide them. لَنَهَدِيَنَّهُمْ سُبُولَنَا. Will show them the guidance. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَمَا الْمُحْسِنِينَ. Indeed, Allah is the good doers. So this ayah itself, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes mention clearly that those who strive harder, وَالَّذِينَ جَهَدُوا فِينَا, those who work harder for Allah's sake, لَنَهَدِيَنَّهُمْ. Allah promised, will show them the guidance, will put them upon the righteousness, upon the right path. Allah is with those who are doing good. And Allah gave a command in the Quran, in Surah Al-Hajj, it says, وَجَاهِدُوا فِي اللَّهِ حَقَّ جِهَادِهِ. Strive hard for Allah with the true way of jihad. Don't do today, tomorrow, you're lazy, you fall back. Stand up, جَاهِدُوا فِي اللَّهِ. Strive hard, work harder. Be a hard worker people, حَقَّ جِهَادِهِ, the true way of working harder for Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. And when Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam qala an Abi Hurairah radiyallahu anhu, احرس على ما ينفعك واستعن بالله ولا تعجزن. Also the messenger said in this narration that from Abu Hurairah, احرس, be eager to do that which bring benefit to you. احرس على ما ينفعك. Spend time. Be eager to do that which brings benefit to you and seek help from Allah. استعن بالله. We always need help from Allah Azza wa Jal. We work hard, but at the same time, we need Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's help. ولا تعجزن. Do not give up. Do not say, oh, I'm going to fall back. So do spend time. احرس. Be eager to do that which brings benefit to you and seek help from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wala ta'jazan, do not give up. And this to work harder for those bring you benefit is benefit in dunya and hereafter. Yanfa'uka fi dunyaka wa akhiratika. That which benefits you here in this life. Work harder to provide for your family, to make halal means. Work harder, put time for that as well. So don't just do the knowledge and you forget they have family under you who need you. Then you say, okay, I'm going to just go for hereafter. No, you put time for all of this that bring you benefit for you and your family in this dunya and for hereafter. لا تعجزن, do not give up. Do not be from those who go for a little few miles, then they sit down, then they stop. أي أن العجز قد يكون أهون من الكسل فإنه قد يكون بسبب مرض. Keep in mind, sometimes a person may give up because he had good reason. Maybe, you know, he's not able to continue, he became sick, or he lost all his money, and sometimes a person just lazy. But so to not to do something, to give up, if it's because you have valid reason, Yeah, you're not, you're not able to pay. Maybe they're asking for payment for that particular lessons people giving, or it requires the traveling, go far away. So you're not able to pay. That, you know, is little less evil than a person who is just lazy. Because a person may not be able to do something because, you know, he's sick, or, you know, some issues came about, or it became older person. The age has passed. Certain age you reach, you cannot be traveling anymore. You're 85. You're not going to go seek knowledge in Egypt or Morocco. You're 85 years old. You know, you need to stay one place because your health, maybe your strength. But the laziness is not praiseworthy ever. Laziness, فَإِنَّهُ مَذْمُومُ مُطْلَقًا. Laziness is never praised one time. But I just not to continue. A person may have an excuse, as you mentioned, but to just be lazy. You have the ability, you have the means. You are a healthier person, but you just don't want to go there to benefit. That is not good for a person who believes in Allah Azza wa Jal. And he mentioned, say, in this dua from the Messenger, Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min al-ajzi wal-kasal. The Messenger used to make this dua, among the dua they used to make, alayhi salatu wasalam, O Allah, I seek refuge with you from the ajz, from giving up, or from laziness, from being lazy. So, Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min al-ajzi wal-kasal. It's from the supplications that the Messenger used to use, to show that to be a person who give up is not right. To be a person who is lazy is not right, but a person who might give up or might stop continuing because he has a good excuse, that might be understandable. But a person just lazy, doesn't want to do anything. This will leave the time, listen. People just want to watch movie, sit around, talk, and go here and there. But on the stuff that don't bring no benefit to our lives. And and Bukhari mentioned this narration, and rahimahullah, from Ibn Abbas radiyallahu anhuma qala rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallama ni'matani maghbunun feehima kathirun minan nas as-sihhatu wal faragh. Then he mentioned this narration from collected by Imam Bukhari from Ibn Abbas. He said the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallama said ni'matan, two bounty many people are don't realize how they are wasting them without realizing they've been wasted. Ni'matani maghbunun feehima kathirun minan nas. A lot of people been cheated, or a lot of people do not benefit from this two bounty, from this two ni'mah that most of people have. That people have them, but because they do not realize the importance of this two bounty that a human being have, then they are cheating themselves or they are wasting the benefit. One is a suha. Suha is when a person is healthy. The health that you have, this is nema. So a person is healthy, does not realize, just wasting time, go here and there, gym or whatever people do that don't bring no benefit. Then next thing you know, you're sick. You become sick now. You wish you can be healthy again. The stuff that you delay to do when you're healthier, you cannot do them now because now you are sick. So when you're sick is a ni'ma, is a bounty. When you're healthier, to be healthy is a bounty from Allah Azza wa Jal. Many people are wasting this bounty. They do not realize the benefit of it. Wal farah. Farah is when a person does not have a lot of responsibilities. You have free time. Like a person don't have a wife, don't have children. You have a lot of time, even if you may go to school. But when a person become married man, now we got one child, two, three, four, then your time is limited. You got to do things to provide for the children you have, for your wife. So it's not like a person who is single, don't have no children, so their time, they have a lot of time on their hands to benefit with their religion. But when people wasting this bounty, so the Messenger named them as a bounty or describe them as a bounty, because it's not many people have this bounty. It's not everybody has this opportunity to have a free time on their hands or to be healthy all the time. So a person is healthy, it does not realize that the healthy might be taken away. There's no guarantee that you're going to be healthy all the time. There's no guarantee you're going to be free all the time. You're free now, you might not be free tomorrow. So this is the ni'mah that many people have been cheated of. Many people wasting this bounty. The bounty of being healthy and the bounty of having time in your hands. So once you have these two bounties, benefit from them. Do not waste them. You are healthier, and then you might be healthier, but you don't have free time. But that little time that you have, come use it because you're healthy and you're healthy. So you may have free time, but you're not healthy. Then you don't have nothing to do, but you're really, really sick. So you cannot really do anything. So these go together. But a lot of time you might be healthier, but you're not free, but sometimes you get a little time here and there, use it. But you may be free, but you are sick, you cannot do nothing. So healthy is important. To be healthy is important. So it's a ni'mah that approaches people. You're wasting this ni'mah without realizing the importance of it. Al-Hafiz ibn Kathir mentioned in the meaning of this ayah, Surah Al-Takathur, ثُمَّ لَتُسْأَلُنَّ يَوْمَئِذٍ عَنِ النَّعِيمِ. Then you'll be questioned يَوْمُ الْقِيَامَةِ about the bounty of Allah. They said the meaning of this bounty that Allah mentioned here in this ayah, لَتُسْأَلُنَّ عَنِ النَّعِيمِ, is not just about money. It's also everything that's considered to be bounty. Your health, your time that Allah bestowed upon you. All this Allah will ask, what did you do with your time? What did you? How you benefited you when you made you a healthier person? You barely got sick. What did you benefit? So ثُمَّ لَتُسْأَلُنَّ يَوْمَئِذٍ عَنِ النَّعِيمِ. Then it will be questioned that day about the bounty of Allah upon you. So those who do not show Allah gratitude, they do not benefit from the bounty of Allah upon them, there'll be question. And those who do not, the time they have on their hands, do something, bring them benefit to them in this dunya and hereafter, there'll be question yawm al-qiyam. So if whoever does not benefit, who are maghboon, he's a loser. He's a person who is like a person you go to buy something that's not really good. You spend all this money on a car that you cannot start. So you are maghboon, a person who, someone, they cheat, they give you wrong thing for something you pay for. So Allah Azza wa Jal, and this ayah, Imam Ibn Kathir mentioned that Allah will ask people about the bounty bestowed upon them, the time you have, the health before you become sick, and the freedom that you have, the free time you have before you become busy. And the nafs, when nafs la budda laha min ahad amrayn, a person, when you are you yourself, you're going to be in one, two situations. Everybody, you're going to be in one, two situations. One, imma an tushghala fi ta'ati Allah. Nafs, your nafs, either you're going to make your nafs busy in obedience to Allah. Is your choice. So you're going to be in one or two conditions. Any person, imma an tushghala fi ta'ati Allah. Yourself, you might make yourself busy in obeying Allah Azza wa Jal. Or wa imma an tashghala sahiba, or your nafs may make you busy in doing haram. So if you are not making yourself busy in doing that which benefits you, in doing the something the obligations, seek knowledge, your nafs will turn on you, make you busy in doing haram. And this is reality. If you are not doing something for hereafter, you are doing something for dunya. If you are not reading, in many people in their homes, they are not reading, they don't just sit around watching the war. They be watching TV, watching movie, something that don't bring no benefit to them at all, wasting time. So your nafs, you have the choice to make your nafs, yourself, this means yourself, busy in obeying Allah Azza wa Jal, in obedience to Allah, or your own nafs, you will make you busy in something else that does not bring you any benefit. So if you do not make yourself busy, you're going to be made busy. So when you are made busy, you're not going to be good, because you're going to be follow the desire. But if you make yourself busy, make your nafs busy, usually it's doing the right thing, something bring benefit to you in this life or hereafter. So if nafs find someone who put it upright and make it straight, the nafs will come and obey. So either you are busy in obedience to Allah, or your nafs got you busy in disobeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So these two conditions, everybody, that only good. We have this situation. Either you're busy doing something right, or you're busy doing something that's not right, even before Islam. People in the street, either you're busy walking, making money, or you're busy over there doing haram with the people who you're not supposed to be with. Either you get a job, you go to work, or you go to school. If you're not going to school, you're just home, busy doing that is not permissible. If it's a female or man, if you're not having a job that benefits you, or a child is not going to school, you're going to be playing, wasting time. So either you are busy worshiping Allah Azza wa Jal, or your nerves make you busy wasting your time. What Imam Shafi'i mentioned, rahimahullah, one of the statements Imam Shafi'i said, "Jalastu Sufiyata falam astafid minhum shay'an." So I sat down with the Sufis, you know, he said, but I did not benefit from them anything except this. Al-waqtu kasayfi illam taqta'uhu qata'ak. Says, I benefit two things from the Sufiya when he was sitting with them, trying to check them out, see what they are upon. So I did not see any benefit except the time is like a sword. If you do not cut the time will cut you. So then you cut your time by using your time, that which benefits you. If you do not do that, then your time is cutting you, because whenever the time passes, some of you is passing, some of you is going, it's decreasing. That the meaning of the time will cut you. That means if you are not using your time to bring benefit to you in this life or in the hereafter, then your time will be cutting you. Because whenever time you have, the time you have, the minute goes away, then you some of you is going away as well. That's a reality. The way you look today is not the way you look 20 years ago. You used to be different. You used to be a baby. Now you're a grown man, a grown woman. You got a children for yourself. So the time has passed. You know, a baby, 10 years old can have no babies. They say 5 years old baby, a girl can have no baby because she's still a baby herself. But the time will pass. When it comes a time, when she's going to have babies for herself. So if the time, you don't cut your time, the time is like a safe, like a sword. If you do not use it, use the time benefit, this time will cut you, means will be passing you by. Whenever the time pass by, some of you is also going. So say that's a benefit. Well, number one, he benefit from them Sufiya that the time, this means they was wasting their time. So if you don't, you know, use your time wisely, your time will be cutting you. So it says, well, nafsu illam tushghal shaghalat bil batil. A nafs, if it's not being made busy to do the right thing, will be busy doing the false thing, be the wrong thing. So it's one of the two. You get your nafs busy to do the right thing, or the nafs will be make you busy to do the wrong thing. So that nobody can deny this, the reality. Whenever you wake up in the morning, if you're not doing something right, there's nothing between. Nobody just sit around here between. If there's between them, it's going to be wasting time. It's still evil. So you have to do one of the things. Either you do right or you do wrong. So you benefit from your time, something bring benefit to you, or you're wasting your time. So people with good attention, they're sincere in what they're about to do, they wise, they use their time wisely. They know if the time, you do not cut your time, the time will cut you. That means whenever the time pass, some of you is passing. وَالْحَقُّ فِي مَرَارَةٌ عَلَى النَّفْسِ وَثِقْبَ. But say the truth is always bitter. It's not sweet. Many people don't like the truth. Bring heaviness in you. This was heavy on me. That type of stuff. Because people usually like to hear this statement of desires. Stuff that make them happy. And they don't want to hear something bring fear in their heart. So the haqq is heavy. Is heavy on people, but the haqq is helping you to remove yourself from the desires. As you mentioned, this narration of Abu Huraira, the Messenger said, "Alayhi salatu wasalam, hujibatil jannatu bil makarihi, wa hujibatil naru bil shahawat." The paradise is surrounded by that which you don't like. So if you want to get to paradise, the road is not going to be sweet. It's not going to be with road with flowers and roses. No, the road is going to be with bumps and difficult times and get tired. So حُجِبَتْ الْجَنَّةُ بِالْمَكَارِ. The paradise is surrounded with that which people dislike. You have to make yourself wake up in the morning to pray on time. You got to make yourself read the Quran. Make yourself travel there to sit in a class. Make yourself do this and that. So all this path to enter paradise is not sweet. It's not easy to just say, it's easy way. No, that's what the Messenger said. Bil makarihi is surrounded with that which is not sweet. But the hellfire also is surrounded with the desires. As we see in everyday life, everything that desire, usually they haram. Most of the desire, I know this halal desire, I know, but the halal desire has a limit. You eat your food from halal, you have your wife, it's a desire, boy, it's halal, you marry her, alhamdulillah. But most of the desire out there people after is usually haram. So these are the things that the hellfire is surrounded by, the desires. With exception of the halal desire, a wife, halal food, halal drink, halal car you drive, you desire a certain type of car, you bought this car, it's desire, it's halal. But a lot of desire people after, they are haram. That's why the Messenger said, the hellfire is surrounded by the desires, but the Jannah is surrounded that which people dislike, makari. So they are also from that thing, that from the desire that the nafs have, is to love falling back, laziness, loving to sleep, to lay down, to just talk, you know, kicking it, chill. All this desire in the kasal. But if you make yourself used to be a hard work person, to study and not to sleep all the time, then the nafs slowly will come and be obedience to you based upon what you wanted to become. So because from the shahawat that a person have as a habit, which is surrounded by the hellfire, is the kasal, to love to sit around, watching movie, talk, be on the phone, be on the social media, go here and there. So it's kasal, laziness. But if you try to make yourself all the time to change, to be right, then inshallah ta'ala, the nafs will come, be the person who supposed to be. Then he mentioned this narration of Abdullah ibn Abbas. احفظ الله يحفظك. Preserve Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then Allah preserve you. Allah is in your mind all the time. You don't waste no time. Allah is in your thought. Allah azza wa jalla's commands come before anything. When you wake up in the morning, your agenda for that day, the obligations come, the salah, which everything you do, you make a connection to ibadah, to worship Allah. Even if you go to do shopping for your family, you make that as ibadah. Your attention is to please your family. So to follow the commands of the Messenger when he said, the best of you is the best to his family. So everything you do as a person believing in Allah, you make that to be connected to a type of worship. So that's how ihfadillah yahfadka, preserve Allah, Allah will preserve you. And this from the 40 hadith. So he says, "Alam anna nafsaka bimanzil." Ibn Rajab mentioned is explaining to make this narration clear. This piece of this narration says, "Alam anna nafsaka bimanzilati dabbatika mink." Should know that your soul is like your animal that you own. For in alimat minka aljidda, if your animal see in you like you. You hardworking person, whatever you teach that animal to do, as a hard running, do this, the animal will do exactly what you want the animal to do. If you just sit there with it, lazy, taking a nap, the animal will be right there sitting there, do the same thing you do. So see, your soul is like your animal, that your animal, though you train your animal, whatever you do with the animal follows your footsteps and listen to what you do. Those animals that are, obey their master and do follow the orders. If you sit down, don't do anything, the animal is not going to do anything, going to just lay down and sit there. So you have to control your soul to make your soul not to be from those souls that are lazy. والذي يضبط نفسه عند حدها فلا يتجاوز الحلال إلى المحرمات. And also the nafs must be controlled. The person controls his own self, so he did not go beyond the halal, go past the halal, go to the haram. There's a limit. Person control himself. He does not allow himself to go beyond. It's halal, it's halal. Haram is haram. You don't leave the halal, go to haram. Or ولا تترك الطاعات. You do not leave the obedience to Allah. If you have this type of soul, this type of nafs, هذا يعد من الجهاد. This is a type of jihad. Jihad nafs. You make yourself obeying Allah Azza wa Jal. So the nafs that is controlled, stop with halal, don't go to the haram. The nafs that does not leave out to obedience to Allah Azza wa Jal. This type of nafs, يعد من الجهاد. To do this is considered from jihad. As came in this narration of Ubaid an-Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, he said, the Messenger said, alayhi salatu wasalam, al-mujahidu man jahada nafsahu fi sabilillahi azza wa jal. Mention this narration as evidence. If you fight yourself to be upright, say al-mujahid, the true mujahid, the one who is on a jihad, is the one who fighting his own self on the path of Allah azza wa jal. So a person, it is haram that he desires, but he's not going there. He stick with the halal, even though he like that haram very much. He want to get that house, but that house, so you don't have the money. So the bank inviting him to pay for him, so he want to pay the bank with the riba. He does not go there. And as much as his dream house, his dream car, but he doesn't have cash to buy the car, has to go to a bank. The bank, he send him letters, come, we're going to give you the money, so you're going to pay us slowly. He does not go there because he knows that it's not permissible. This type of nafs is jihad. The person is mujahid. As he said, al-mujahidu, the real mujahid, is the person who fighting himself in the path of Allah Azza wa Jal. And Ibn Battal mentioned in the Fath al-Bari, jihadu al-mar'i nafsahu huwa al-jihadu al-akmal. The jihad, the person fight his own self, that the complete, that the perfect jihad. Because it's not easy jihad. There's no weapons, there's no guns or spears or swords, but to fight yourself, to give up desires, yeah, you gotta be blessed. It's not easy. So that's what you say. And that's why the ulama or the past mentioned this jihad is jihadul akman. Is a perfect jihad. Other jihad, a person might go to show off. Person might go to fight in jihad, but he wanted to be seen as a brave man. But to fight your own desire, you're not going to do that to be seen. Because a lot of times desire just between you and your nafs. You're someplace, nobody sees you. But there's desire right there. So when you fight yourself not to go to that desire, you have the ability, that is a perfect jihad. Because the jihad in the battlefield, people in the past happened at the time of the messenger, and even the messenger mentioned in narration, man qatala litakuna kalimatullahi hiya al-uliya fahuwa fi sabila. Whoever fight to establish the word of Allah, tawheed in the land, he's fi sabilillah. That's jihad in the battlefield. But that far battlefield, a person may be fighting there to be named as a brave. Came in a narration, a person who Allah will ask yawm al-qiyam, a person who Allah gave me, made him brave. Say, I made you brave and I gave you power and strength. And you what do you do? The man will say, qataltu fika. I fought for you, Allah. The answer will be kadhabta. You lie. You fought so people can say jari is a brave man. And that was said about you, your jari. Okay, that's jihad in battlefield. But jihad in nafs, cannot be no riyah on that. Cannot be showing off a person fighting his own self. How can I be showing off? I mean, a lot of you by yourself. You can be in your car. You can be in your house. You can be anywhere. Do whatever you want to do. So that's why the ulama mentioned, jihad in nafsi is jihad al-akmal. It's a jihad that's complete. Because it's not easy to fight your own self. I mentioned Allah Azza wa Jalla said in the Quran, وَأَمَّا مَنْ خَافَ مَقَامَ رَبِّهِ وَنَهَى النَّفْسَ عَنِ الْهَوَى فَإِنَّ الْجَنَّةَ هِيَ الْمَأْوَى. As for the one who fear to stand in front of his Lord, the one who is afraid of being questioned يوم القيامة, he's afraid of مَقَامَ رَبِّهِ, to stand there talking to his Lord, be questioned. وَنَهَى النَّفْسَ عَنِ الْهَوَى. So this fear that he has, the fear of standing in front of Allah يوم القيامة, led him to stop himself from following the desire. وَنَهَى النَّفْسَ عَنِ الْهَوَى. He prevent himself from following desires. This person, فَإِنَّ الْجَنَّةَ هِيَ الْمَأْوَى. Indeed, the Jannah, it will be his abode. He will be staying in the Jannah because he's a person who was afraid of standing in front of Allah Azza wa Jal, and that fear helped him to prevent his nafs, himself, from following the desire. So فَإِنَّ الْجَنَّةَ هِيَ الْمَأْوَى. So paradise will be his place. So the other point I want to go over with al-a'da'u thalatha. They mentioned three types of enemies we have in ourselves. We have in our lives, I should say, three types of enemies we have. The ulama mentioned al-a'da'u, al-shaytan, al-nafs. You have the real enemy, al-a'da'u, and the person who don't like you, person who wish harm for you, person who might come after you, like before Islam, people looking for each other to kill each other. That's your enemies, your a'da'u. Click, you cannot go in that neighborhood, you cannot do this. It's your adu. That's adu, that the normal adu that everybody knows. Those people, they're enemies, they don't talk. they cannot go sit each and see each other face to face. That's one enemy that you might be able to protect yourself. And Ash-Shaytan, the devil, that also is known as our enemy. Shaytan is also another enemy, number two. And Nafsu, also your own self. Your soul is your enemy. So for Nafsu Aduwa, so here we're discussing the Nafs. So these are the two, we are going to go in details in this Adu, number one, number two, the enemy, the real enemy that we know from ourselves, from human being, the human like you, and a shaitan, the enemy that is the shaitan, is known, we don't see, but there's a nafs. So a nafsu aduwa, nafs is enemy. Is enemy that na tadu'u ila dhatiha wa shahawatiha, because the nafs always inviting you to follow the desire. Because nafs is you, so you always inviting yourself to do this and that. Make you believe that you have more time. Make you believe that I can do it. You can start next year. You only 35. You only 40. Sometimes you only 50. Oh, so don't worry. So nafs make you follow the desire. Make you believe that you have long days. You have a whole lot of time ahead of you. So you have nothing to worry about. So here في داخل جوف صاحبها فكما أن عنده أعداء في الخارج عنده أعداء في الداخل. So this nafs is inside you, is with you. Nafs is you. Just like you have enemies outside, you have enemies inside yourself. So nafs is your enemy. As you have adu, the real enemy from human being, and shaitan, and a nafs. وإن تزكية النفوس لذات أهم لذات أهمية بالغة. When it says get a nufusi, so to purify the souls. To purify the souls has importance in the deen. Very important to purify, to make yourself righteous, to do right. قَالَ تَعَالَى قَدْ أَفْلَحَ مَنْ زَكَّاهَا وَقَدْ خَابَ مَنْ دَسَّاهَا. He succeed, the one who purifies his own self. The one who purifies his soul. So tazkiyatun nufusi is important. لَذَاتُهَا مِنْيَةٌ بَالِغَ has importance in our lives. But Allah said, قَدْ أَفْلَحَ مَنْ زَكَّاهَا. He succeeded, the one who purified himself. Make himself do right. وَقَدْ خَابَ مَنْ دَسَّاهَا. And he's a loser, the one who corrupts his own self. He's a loser, he has nothing. He corrupted his own self, live his life upon sins, upon stuff that are not permissible. This is a khaib, a person who lose. So the saha corrupt his own self. وَبِتَسْكِيَةِ النُّفُوسِ يُقْمَعُ الشَّيْطَانُ وَتُنَالُ الْجِنَانِ. And by purifying oneself, the shaitan will be defeated. Because the only way to defeat shaitan is when you purify yourself. Shaitan will be defeated and the Jannah will be reached by purifying yourself. Bi-idhnillahi rabbil alameen, by the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So purifying oneself is the weapon to remove shaitan. You always have Allah in your mind. Taking care of yourself. You obey Allah Azza wa Jal. The worship in your agenda. And everything you do, they are connected to the worship, to the type of worship that you do every day. So he mentioned, وَلَيْسَ هُنَاكَ خَسَارَةَ أَعْظَمُ مِنْ أَنْ يَخْسِرَ الْإِنسَانُ نَفْسَهُ الْكَرِيمَةِ. There's nothing really compared to be a loser, like a person. There's no losing. Very bad loser, like a person who loses own self. I mean, everybody love themselves. Everybody is supposed to care for themselves. But now you're doing some things that will make you become a loser. So he said, there's no losing position is greater and more bad for a person than the person who losing his own self. Allah says, قُلْ إِنَّ الْخَاسِرِينَ الَّذِينَ خَسِرُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ وَأَهْلِيهِمْ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ أَلَا ذَلِكَ هُوَ الْخُسْرَانُ الْمُبِينَ. Say, indeed, the losers, the true losers, are the ones who lose their own selves and their family and the day of resurrection. A person خَسِرُ أَنفُسَهُمْ has nothing, has no dunya or hereafter. Also, he lost his family as well. Not in his family. If the family in the Jannah, is not in the Jannah. Or those who supposed to get, if he went to Jannah, he's not going to have them because it's not in the Jannah. So he lost himself and he lost the family. That for Allah ذَلِكَ وَالْخُسْرَانُ الْمُبِينَ. For sure, that is a plain losing. There's no losing like that. Person lost himself and he lost his family. Now, also we have this narration here. Before that, فَلِهَذَا عَلَيْنَا نُحَاسِبَ أَنفُسَنَا قَبْلَ أَن تُحَاسَبَ. So it's upon us to control ourselves before we are controlled, to put ourselves in a reckoning, to check ourselves before somebody check you. So if you want to be a successful person, always حَاسِبْ نَفْسَكَ. فَلِهَذَا عَلَيْنَا نُحَاسِبَ أَنفُسَنَا is upon us to check ourselves قَبْلَ أَن تُحَاسَبَ. Before these souls are questioned, have been checked. وَهَذَا أَبْلَغُ فِي التَّأْثِيرِ عَلَيْهَا. And this is, has major effects on the person when you check yourself all the time. You check yourself, this has major effects in our lives. And if also, I mentioned this narration from Abdullah ibn Amr. وَلِنَفْسِكَ عَلَيْكَ حَقَّ. Yourself, your nafs has right upon you. Al-Hadith, your nafs has a right, but this right does not mean you waste time or you go for fun all the time. There's a limit. There's a limit you don't support to pass. Yeah, nobody even able to just read every second you end the book. It's not possible. Or you are making salah all the time. It's not possible. Or you are reading Quran every hour. It's not possible. So you pray tahajjud all night. It's not possible. So your nafs has a right. You worship and you go to sleep like the messenger said. Then you have time for your family, time for you to. But there should be a limit. Not so much time of relaxing. Not so much time of pushing yourself harder. No resting. That's not right. But you give right. You give yourself the right with the limit. You're aware of the timing. I'm taking a break for an hour. I'll do something. One of these things we can do. To continue to do right, but without wasting time. You might stop reading by now, helping your family do certain things. Have nothing. It's not reading a book anymore, but are doing some other things in the house, helping the family. Still in a bad. So you're not wasting time. Or you can go your family, do some shopping, and buy some food. You still drive her somewhere, she can drive by herself. All this is still in the bad. If you're near, it's purified. So nafs has a right, but does not mean you go too far. With relaxing. وَالصِّحَّةُ لَا تَدُومُ. Keep in mind, وَالصِّحَّةُ لَا تَدُومُ. The health is not going to be here forever. The health don't last. And that's the reality. وَالصِّحَّةُ لَا تَدُومُ. فَلَا بُدَّ أَن يَعْقُبُهَا سُقْمُ. The health is not going to be here forever. It's going to come after healthy. It's going to come sickness. When the person is healthy, then they're going to be healthy for some time. Then, and then they say, even if it's let's say you never got sick. Some people, mashallah, they barely get sick. But one thing is coming. You are aging. Aging. The certain age you reach, even if you are old man with health condition, but certain things you cannot do. Just for the fact of the age, you want to stop you doing those certain things. So this is the reality. So wasuha, the health does not stay forever. La tadum. فَلَا بُدَّ يَعْقُبُهَا سُقْمُ. There's no doubt that after health will come sickness. Then they say, وَلَوْ لَمْ يَكُنْ إِلَّا كِبَرُ السِّنِّ فَإِنَّ كَبِيرَ السِّنِّ يُعَاقُ عَنِ الْعَمَلِ بِسَبَبِ الشَّيْخُوخَةِ الَّتِي قَدْ حَلَّتْ بِهِ. So, even a person is not sick, but the age is going. So some people blessed, like we say, they don't be sick all the time. They look healthy, but the age is not stopping. Certain age, even if you're a healthy old man, you're not gonna do certain things. You're gonna be able to read all the time. Even if you're not be able to stuff you used to do when you're younger, we cannot do them. So that keep that in mind as well. Don't say, man, I never got sick. Alhamdulillah, I'm healthy, man. But you are aging. When I come this age, they're going to have to slow down things. You like or not. You have no choice. So that itself should be a reminder. So now you're young. You have this energy. Do whatever you can do now. But with a certain age, you cannot do this speed anymore. You cannot run the track on 85. You cannot walk from here to there. You're 80 years old, man. You cannot do that. You cannot pray tahajjud 3-4 hours a night. You can't do that. So because the age has made you to slow down, even though you are old man with health. So that's what the reason they mention. The age comes. You're not, health don't last. Sickness will come, but even if you are not sick, the age will not pass you by.
And sickness may pass you by. You never got to say about the age with everybody. So nobody exempt.
فَصِحَّةُ تُعِينُ الْمُوَفَّقَةَ عَلَى شُؤُونِ دِينِ. So the health will help a person who, those who, if you follow this, some lines, I'll skip some lines. So وَصِحَّةُ تُعِينُ الْمُوَفَّقَةَ عَلَى شُؤُونِ دِينِهِ وَدُنِيَا. The person who is healthy, صِحَّة is helping you to achieve the affairs of your deen and dunya. When you are healthy, you can read the Quran, you can travel to seek knowledge, you can go there, you can do a lot of things with, because you have you are a healthy man and you have energy. So this the health will help a person who is a muwaffaq, a person who has been given tawfiq, successful person, because that person may be healthy, but if he doesn't have no tawfiq, just sit there with, he's a healthy guy, but never do nothing. Just on a chair all day, healthy guy. But he always sit in this chair all day long. So his worst thing is the health. So the health goes away. So he says, a person who is healthy, but muwaffaq, we help the person who is muwaffaq to establish the affairs of the deen and dunya. وقد قال الصديق أبو بكر رضي الله عنه. This narration from Abu Bakr Siddiq رضي الله عنه. He said, سألوا الله المعافاة فإنه لم يؤت أحد بعد اليقين خير من المعافاة. Ask Allah to make you healthy. Ask Allah to bestow upon you healthy. For sure, nobody. فإنه لم يؤت أحد بعد اليقين. Nobody was given something better after being given the certainty, yaqeen, to believe without doubt, like health. When a person, some people, they have doubt in things of Islam. A person, you know, though, but they doubt some stuff. So he says, ask Allah to give you health, to make you a healthier person. Indeed, nothing better that a person will be given after is given the yaqeen, the ability to believe without doubt, other than health. So yaqeen is on top, then come mu'afa, the person with afia. You are a healthy person, you are not complaining about sickness, you know, you don't have any kind of pain, nothing at all, you are alhamdulillah. So this is bounty, is a khayr, is a ni'mah from Allah, after being a person who understand yaqeen. You have yaqeen in your belief, you don't have no doubt. So ba'd ahad ma'd al-yaqeen khayru min al-mu'afa. This from narration from Ibn Majah from Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu. And wa ma min insanin taqiyyin farata fi waqtihi wa sihhatihi wa lam yaghtanimha illa nadima. I said, there's nobody who is righteous, nobody who fears Allah azza wa jal, but he wastes a lot of time. When he was healthy, he did not really take advantage of his health. But he's going to come a time where he will regret. He would nadim wa tahassar. And some of us have gone through that. You wish, man, I wasted a lot of time when I was in school. I wish I had done this and that, man. And now, you know, you look back, you realize you wasn't working harder enough. You could be working harder, could be on a higher level than what you have now. But time has passed, so nobody who has some righteousness, taqi, farrata, he was time in his time and his health, walam yaghtanima, did not take advantage of those time and those healthy and the healthy hand, illa nadima, except he will regret, and tahassara. So not tahassara, to regret, and even lead you to cry, because nadima is regret, and tahassara, another level. A person is regret and really with the pain, man. I don't know. So wahuzn wabaka, then he cry. Wasaidu manita'adha bighayrihi. And the happy person is the one who learned from him by looking at the people. What happened to them, then for you become a lesson. Not the one who people learn from what happened to you. You are not the better person. For people learn from what happened to you, look at you now. People learn from your mistake, but you're about to learn from other people's mistake that make you a better person. So another narration. Probably the last narration in this chapter. وَذَلِكَ الْفَرَاغُ. Keep in mind that the free time you have will be taken away from you today or tomorrow. That's no doubt. الْفَرَاغُ سَيُسْلَبُ الْيَوْمَ أَوْ غَدًا. That the free time you have will be taken away today or tomorrow.
Lihada, therefore, the Messenger said in the hadith narration in a Muslim from the hadith of Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu qala, qala Rasulullah sallam, badiru bil amali fitana. The Messenger said, badiru, hurry up to establish this, to establish actions, to do better, to better yourself before trials come. This trial, they come so fast like a piece of dark night. Boom, the night has fallen. It's night time. A person is rajul mu'mina, or msi kafira. A person is in the morning is a believing man or believing woman, but before the sun set is a kafir. And this time we have seen those issues. Yabiu dinahu bi'aradi min ad-dunya. He sells his deen for a little bit dunya. The sincerity is not there. The niyyah was impure. So the Messenger given advice from this hadith of Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu. He said, the Messenger said, hurry up to do actions before trials and tribulation happen, take place. They come so fast, quickly, like a piece of dark night. A man wake up in the morning, he is a believer. You see him in Salatul Fajr, he prays. Maybe read Quran after that. Well, you see kafir in the evening, he's a kafir. See people used to be upright, they stray. People used to be close to them, they're no longer close. A lot of things happen, you see. A lady was married, she have niqab, gloves. Now she got divorced, she doesn't have anything. You see in Walmart, you don't realize that's the same lady. She changed. She was a believing woman in the morning, in the afternoon she got divorced. She's no longer Muslim. So they hurry to do the righteous actions before this happened to you. So that means keep up with your nafs. Keep up to be a right person, to do what you're supposed to do as a believing man, because you never know. There's a fitna comes quickly like a nighttime falls. Then the person is Muslim in the morning, and afternoon is a kafir. He sells his deen. How many people apply for a job? The job is clearly haram. Your lady go to this job, is intermingling, you cannot wear your jilbab here, we're not allowing that, she take the job anyway. That's how you sell your deen for dunya. So there'd be a person, this job here, you gotta shave, we don't want to take these people here, so you go here and shave. Yeah, people deen will be out of them in dunya because they're a little bit money gonna be getting. So this is the advice. وَكَانَ مِنْ تَوْجِهَاتِ الْوَالِدِ رَحِمَهُ اللَّهُ اشتهدوا قبل أن تأتيكم الصوارف. She said was from the advice from the father. She pointed out, she meant Sheikh Muqbil, from the advice of the father used to say اشتهدوا. Well, he used to tell his children, رحمه الله, اشتهدوا قبل أن تأتيكم الصوارف. Work harder before things come that will take you away from that. That's the reality. If you don't have a job, you have time, you can read, you can study, you can do it, but when you know you have a job, 8 hours a day, and this job might be a labor, might be them job that may get you really tired. You get home, you get in the shower, you want to lay down. Really, now you go one day, you to read every day, now you go one day, 2 days, 3 days, you get a week, you open a book now. Now, you forget, because now before you got this job, you used to read. So she said, the father used to tell us, اشتهدوا قبل أن تأتيكم الصوارف. Work harder before things come to you that will take you away from that اجتهاد, from that hard work. والمشاغل تتنافى مع طلب العلم. And to have a lot of, to be busy, to have a lot of work to do for life is in opposition to seek knowledge. I don't know, والمذاكرة والحفظ, and to study knowledge, إذا كثرت. If the person is busy with a lot of things, and this is a reality we see. If you got two jobs, for example, you got to do this and that, you got a large family, you're not going to be like a person who don't have, you got three wives. You're not going to be like a person who got one wife. If both of you are studious, you like to study the religion, you and the person with one wife are not going to be the same, because you got three wives. That's a lot of time to spend. She's calling you, got children here. I'm going to do, you're going to divide your time between the family. This one can only go one. So your schedule cannot be the same. So that's, he says, the busy situation does not go along with seek knowledge. Or mudhakara, even when the people sit down and study together. Mudhakara will have the memorization, especially to sit down with the brothers or to study. Idha kathurat, فَإِنَّهَا تُضْعِفُ الذَّاكِرَ. When there's a lot of stuff to do, you have a lot of stuff going on in your life, they make the memory weak. Because that's right, because you have a lot of stuff in your mind. That's why the knowledge in the younger age stayed. It's like a naqshful hajar, like, you know, you are writing on a stone. So younger age, they absorb everything you tell them, because they're younger, they have nothing, they have no bills to pay, no argument, you're just there. So when you are aging, things happen in your life. So your brain is you have other thoughts, you have a wife now, you have maybe children, you have so, and these things make your dhakira weak, make your memory strength become weak, because you have other things intact. Like you have a hard drive that's full. When hard drive is full, the computer crash. So you gotta empty it. So you cannot empty your hard drive, because it's a life that you have. You gotta do this and that. So now your dhakira cannot be like a person who is young age, he has no bills, no responsibility, he's gotta memorize. So that's what I say with the meaning here. So the memory become weak if you have a lot of things to do. What you have, if we find in the past some of the scholars in the past, once they became leaders, like Sharik, when he became leader, Qadi, he forgot some of the stuff he memorized. Sahif, his memorization became bad because he was busy now. Besides Shawar, now he's a leader. He was leading the he was a judge over in a city, over the judge of the land, the judge of the country. So now the time of reading is not like the time he had before he became on a position. We finish with this ayah here. قال الله تعالى قل إن صلاتي ونسكي ومحياي ومماتي لله رب العالمين. Allah says, say, O Muhammad, indeed my prayer and my sacrifice and my living, my death, all belong to Allah. This ayah is mentioned here to let you know that أوقاتنا, all everything we have belong to Allah. أوقاتنا ملك لله. Our time is belong to Allah Azza wa Jal. So that not, you don't own anything. So this as say, Imasallah, my sacrifices, my living, my death belong to Allah. So this means time. Your life is time. You hear, everything you do is based upon time. So it belongs to Allah Azza wa Jal. So whatever is belong to Allah, وما كان ملكا لله فإنه لا يجوز التصرف فيه إلا بإذنه. Whatever belongs to Allah is not appropriate to be used to that which opposing Allah's command. Because it belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah may take it away from you, and you may be without time. You may be laying in the bed sick, you cannot do anything. Now the time that you have, you cannot use it anymore. So take time to benefit from your time, and have your time that bring benefit to you. Have your time as ra'su malik, the wealth, the capital of your wealth is your time. So as especially, so she threw the advice for women, especially before you have babies, خصوصاً قبل إنجاب الأطفال, before you have children, لأن الفراغ يكون أكثر. Before the babies come, you have more time. But the one who got babies, the time is not like the one who got no babies, because her time now has to be between the children and herself, also the husband. So the time gonna be reduced. When she have 5 hours a day to read, now she know she can't have 5 hours anymore, because she got a baby's crying over there. She wanna leave the book here, go to the baby hungry, gotta breastfeed or feed the baby. So husband is home and he's calling her. So the time before having children is plenty time, is better and is more time than a person who have children. Once they have children, they don't have more. They're not gonna have the same time that they had before having babies. And a single man is not like a person who's married. Person who's single got more time than person who's married. One wife more time than two wives. One child more time than two children, and so on and so forth. So here, it actually point out to take time before you have children, before you are married, because once you become mother, you become a wife, the time will be divided between you and children and your husband. So that's the reality. Wallahu al-musta'an. We're going to end up here tonight. Inshallah, we're going to continue. Next chapter coming up, Hifdhul Lisan, to preserve your tongue. Wala ilmu inda Allahi ta'ala. Wa subhanakallahumma bihamdika. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.